YouTube. So yeah, today we've got this Holden Statesman. We're doing both sides, so a bit of a repair over here. Rear bumper, I'm doing that little flute, and we've got a bit of work to do over on the other side too. So obviously it's all masked up, and I pointed the cam back on myself there so that you could see I've got this throat mic, and it clips around my throat. So thanks to the YouTube user who, I can't remember your name, but thanks to the guy who told me about these things, I didn't even know they existed, and I believe they're like, you know, you see security guys and they'll be in like loud concerts, they'll have those little earpieces. I never saw this thing around their neck, but it's obviously what they use. So it basically cuts out all the ambient sound, for, like background noise and stuff like that. So I did some tests at home with it, and it did turn out like it sounded quite tinny, like high pitched. I've got a feeling that's possibly because it's just a cheap $20 eBay one. Partly I just wanted to see if it worked, and they do work. And then I looked into getting a better quality one, and they're hard to find. I tried searching on eBay by price, like highest price, and all it really comes up is like packs of 10 of them. Obviously for, you know, big security events, some companies will buy, like security companies will buy that. They've got the 10, you know, their 10 security guards, and they'd pay $300, but they didn't really seem to be any well-branded versions of them. I may have to go down to something like Jaycar. That's like an electronic supplier here, you know, electronic place here in Australia. So yeah, might go down there on my holiday break or something like that. See if we've got some good quality ones. Get myself a bit of a Christmas present. See if we can improve the audio. But yeah, I still think it's better. Like, you don't get as much of the background sound of the spray gun, and maybe I won't have to yell so much anymore. I guess that's probably just become a bit of a habit by this point. But yeah, so I'm putting the 599 down first. So this basically fills in your prep scratches and helps the blend. Essentially, all it really is basically clear base coat. So it does have a very slight yellow tinge in the pot, but by the time that is, you know, sprayed out to a thin film, it's going to be very small to none that you'll actually end up seeing. And you only really need this on your lighter metallic. So this one's it's probably not a 50-50. It's probably use it every day, but you know, you may have kind of got away with it being a bit of a darker metallic, but there's still, I would say, enough metallic in there for me to use it. So, get this out here so we don't get tangled up too much. So the gun I'm using, so people have been telling me, hey, I know you feel like you've said it 100 times, but they want me to quote the spray guns and the settings a little bit more. So yes, that's probably why I haven't been saying it all the time lately, because I do feel like I've said it 100 times, but we'll go through it again. So this is a 1.2 ANI F-160. I love these guns, they're cheap, and they do well, you know, like, I'm at the point where I don't really want to create any drama anymore, but I've still got to tell the truth. I believe it sprays no worse than a starter jet. Doesn't use any more material, and you can get exactly the same finish. The pots are janky, you know, they don't quite have the build quality of a starter. But yeah, great little guns for stuff like 599. Like, this, I just leave it in here. That stays in there all the time. I don't even clean it out. I don't need to. See, I've got these in 1.2, 3, and 4. And yeah, they're just handy little guns. See, this is a fan adjustment. That's a pressure adjustment. That stays flat out, and I adjust my pressure here. And that's your fluid. So that's not in the way, like on a starter, that's in the way for me. It's like where it's back here, where my thumb is, so I don't like that. And the starter, you have to like hold it like that, and it just feels like an uncomfortable angle, but they've got that little piece there to grab onto it. But as I say, I don't even use that pressure adjustment on these guns anyway, because I just run the regs, the regulators, well, cheater valves, aka regulator or gauge, whatever you want to call it. But yeah, they're $30, those little ANI gauges, man, they're cool, they're really good. They last for years too, if you look after them. Just don't, like, submerge them in thinners every time you clean your gun, and they should last for a long time. Yeah, as I say, I've had them, I've got one out there that must be coming up to 3 years old, and it's still going. And as I say, just give it a really good pack rag down. The less polishing, the better, obviously. We're flat out, like, this job here would have been done last night, but Alan decided to go and break his shoulder. So he's out of action for a while. And I would have got this painted last night, but I had to do the putty up. The boss came in last week and said to all us painters that, hey, I know you guys are under the pump and we're busy, it's coming up to Christmas. So we'll give you the panel beater apprentice who's, you know, a bit of an enthusiast. He's done a bit of work on paintwork and stuff like that at home. And he always seems interested in it and always asks questions to us, even though he is a panel beater. Boss said you can have him to do the primer. Last night I said, hey man, you know, you're going to come in and do the primer up at 2 o'clock. 2:30 rolled around, I got this in the booth, he was still trying to get this panel job repaired, and it just wasn't going to happen, so I have to stop working on this one, and go out and do the primer. So, yeah, look, it's been a busy 3 to 4 weeks here, and it's just at the point where, you know, 2 or 3 weeks without your apprentice, you can kind of pick up the slack, but now it's just like, man, there's only so much I can do. In a way, I haven't given up, but it just feels like an endurance race, you know? And I've been running it like it's a sprint for 4 weeks, and something's going to give if I don't just take a step back and just say, hey, there's only so much I can do, mate. It's not my fault. What's that? I reckon the airline tipped that. God damn it. I've got to clean that off. This is a blend section, so I don't usually blend bumpers, but I had a look at my car and it's like 50-50. It probably would look okay, but I just don't fully trust it. So what are we going to, how are we going to do this? I've already sprayed some 599 down. We'll make it work. Try and clean a bit of it off without making too much of a mess. Good thing I didn't put too much down. You see right on this corner here? That's already gone. I won't need to sand that. That's fine. All good. Crisis averted. Yeah, because I don't want to put colour down there. 599, that's where we were. That's a bit of a chilly morning. Like, considering it's summer, it's a bit colder than what it has been for the last few days, so. As I said, I was going to get this painted yesterday and I put the HVLP cap on my DV1, but I've got the 1.2, so we'll see how that goes. So the pressure is different. So 1 bar, with the digital gauge on these DV1s, they've had to change it, or they may have to, or didn't have to, whatever, but they did change it, and yeah, it's now reading different pressures. So if it says 1 bar here, it's actually 1.5 bar down there. That makes sense. Couple of bits of silicon in there. Not to worry too much, it's just in the base coat for now, but all these tyres on this car had tyre shine on them, and I know people are going to be like, oh man, you know, you could degrease the entire car before it gets in the booth, and it's like, man, thank you, like, I really appreciate, you know, the help and the feedback and the advice, but it's just one of those things. We've got so many jobs out there, we don't have time for it, man. Sometimes it's just quicker and easier to just spray the bloody thing, get a few bits of silicon in it and fill them up. It's not ideal, but it's just the way it is these days, man. It's just flat out, basically, all day, every day. So yeah, this is a DV1, 1.2, well that's what it says on the cap anyway. Who knows what to believe anymore. And then HVLP air cap. So if it was a really stinking hot day, I'd probably go 1.3, which actually measures 1.4. I had it sitting up next to, I had the 1.3 sitting next to my 1.4 on the Pro, or actually it was, not the Pro, it was the GPI. And they're the same size. So, anyway, this 1.2 is actually larger than a 1.3 on the Pro Lite. The mind boggles. As I said, like, on an Instagram post, at least Segola and Iwata give some sort of an indication that their chips are larger, like, I want to do their 1.3 HD, which means high delivery. So, you know, straight before you buy that, you're like, okay, you're getting a bit of an indication that this may be a touch larger. And Segola, they do a 1.3 XL. So, you know, at least it's like, oh, yeah, it might be a bit larger than your standard 1.3. But Sata and DeVilbiss has now decided to follow suit. I don't know why they've decided to just go and change the chip sizes without telling anyone. I'll give it off. But what they have done is said, oh, if you previously had 1.2, you probably want 1.1 and vice versa. But like, go one smaller than you used to. But still, not everyone's going to know that. There's going to be a day, there's going to be people who don't watch my videos, don't stay in touch with all the online stuff. They'll get caught out with the wrong fluid tip because the developers have gone and bullshitted about them. So yeah, there was actually like a little dent here. I couldn't just paint over it, so I just fixed that one myself and used my awesome UV primer and this new UV light that I've got, so I'll be reviewing that one pretty soon. It's great. It's like $950, which is much cheaper than any of the competition, and it's all handheld, like just like a little torch basically. It runs off batteries. I had a tiny little cut through there. That's done, gone, lost cut through. All right, so that looks covered after the two coats, which is good news. Last coat is going to be somewhat of a tech coat. Just letting that dry down for a second. So yeah, I hope you guys can hear me well. I did notice that with this throat mic, it sounded a bit softer, like, so you just maybe, you've probably already done it by now, but you can turn the volume up a little bit. I think this one here was like a rework. There was a repair under there that it all died in like sun damage. It all faded back really bad. I don't know if it was from this shop or another shop, but it's a private job, so it's probably not from this shop. It was from this shop, it would be under warranty and would be fixing it for free, so it wouldn't be a private job. Anyway, not to worry. can't even get that a bit higher. Bloody long bumper bar, this thing. Bumper cover, whatever you want to call it. Yeah, get all that dust off my hands. Touch on the squeezy side today. Yeah, if this booth was just like a meter longer, it would make a big difference, I think. Like, yeah, it's usable. Something we can work around, not a big deal, but in a perfect world, it would be a little bit bigger. Yeah, so we'll give that a bit of a top up. That's flashing off quite nice. Like, from the time I do a round, we'll have to start back at the start again. I set the boost to 25.9, so 26 degrees Celsius. So what did that be? Probably somewhere around 80 Fahrenheit. So what's that? It's, you double it and then you add 30, I think. But that's only a rough calculation. So what is it, 2552, yeah, around 82 Fahrenheit for my American viewers who don't understand Celsius. So what I'm going to do on this last coat is just drop that pressure down a bit. Let's go to 75. You can see on that marking there that goes from full colour to no colour in a nice even blend. It's not like it stops directly under that mirror or anything. So why did I mix up 600 mils of colour? Yeah, 600 mils of colour for this job. So that then gets thinned down at 2:1 or thereabouts. So ended up with about 900 mils, give or take. The colour was pretty good. I did have to do a little bit of matching, not too much. Just matching for a blend, so it didn't have to be perfect. And as I said, I'm blending that rear bumper cover as well. Something I don't usually do. You guys probably know that by now, but if I'm ever like, that may or may not look great, I'll just blend it if I've got room there for it. Yeah, it was like, it looked dark on one angle, light on the other. And rather than rolling the dice, just blend it. The reason I don't usually like to do that is because, for all you know, it could already be a touch out. Sometimes bumpers are a little bit out before you spray them, and then if you go and blend over it, then it's still going to look out. But the way I see it this time is, if they were happy with it before, they should be happy with it now. It's not why the car's in here, it's not in here for a colour difference, so yeah. As I say, I just sort of keep that colour around here, yeah? And around there, it's just the original colour. Just on this side, which is that side, when it's back on the car. So obviously this other side, we're blending the quarter panel, so full colour all the way up. Hopefully that can's still rolling, hasn't overheated by now, but should be right. And I'll go out, clean this gun out. I need to get a new tack rag. That one's getting a touch dirty. Before I clear it, I'll give it all a good tacky. Mix up my clear, come back. I don't even know which gun I'm using now. I've got too many to choose from. And I'll see you in probably 10 minutes. I'm pretty happy with that. The repairs look nice. Veins look nice. Coke stack is in my base coat. Yeah. Radio YouTube. I'll see you back here in 5 minutes. Radio YouTube, back to it. So, yeah, let's get this thing cleared up. Yeah, I'm getting the hang of this throat mic. It's actually not too bad. It's like it's not uncomfortable for me. I've just got a little wire, and yes, yeah, I just tuck the rest of it down inside here, all the wiring, so it's not like it's in the way or anything. And yeah, hopefully we've got some improved audio. As I said, we'll see if we can get an even better one over my Christmas break and improve it, just the quality a little bit more, because yeah, I just feel like it's just a cheap Chinese pumping out this poor quality style thing from eBay. Not uncommon. So yeah, I decided to go with the ProLite TE21.3. So the settings are full fluid, full fan, and full bar. Just give those blend sections a bit of a tack rag. Probably could tack the whole thing, but I can just feel it laying down nice and clean. Yeah, just feels like it's going to come up clean, this one. You just get that feeling after you've been doing this for 18 years. Yeah, I started in the year 2000, started my apprenticeship, so. And I mixed up 1 litre of clear. I'm not going to use it all. My calculations, I think they got me to about 950. I just thought I'll add a 50 mils just in case. I love the control that I get out of my ProLite. One thing I don't, not the biggest fan of some of those guns that just pump it out, like for clear coat anyway, on automotive refinishing like this, where I'm doing smash repairs, I'm going to go for factory orange peel. There's no use in trying to get it too flat or too peely. You've got to replicate the finish that's on the rest of the car. If you go and make it look dead flat, it's just going to look stupid. If you make it look thick and orange peel, it's also going to look stupid. But yeah, you got to look at that car, because they are all sort of unique. You know, a Mazda's got a different finish than a Mercedes or something like that, you know. So I've found that I can replicate all those different finishes with this same gun. Even same settings, just different application. You know, might want to just go a touch quicker and get a little bit less material on with a Mazda and just slow it down a little bit with your BMWs, Mercedes, or Euro style finishes. I had the FLG5 in my hand, I was going to use it, but I'm like, I've got the ProLite down, might as well use it. And honestly, like, with DV1, I don't think that they can really, I don't think there's much room for improvement on this gun here, you know? Ah, time will tell. We'll see how they go. This bumper cover's gonna chew through quite a lot of clear. I think I'll just pack and whack it, just put this first coat on a little bit lighter, but it's still closed. So you want it so that you can't see through to any of the base coat on your first coat, but it's not too heavy. And then follow that up with another wet one, just to wet it back up. All the inside here is unseen. There's a big garnish that sits there, so I didn't spend too much time making it look too pretty. Gotta get all these cars painted, mate. Everyone wants their cars back. The boss wants them all out yesterday. This one was actually meant to go out yesterday. It was on our list, but yeah, we're a bit behind. As I said, due to being a painter down. This is chewing through the material. This bumper cover. They always do, because there's lots of edges. But this one especially, because it's just an extra large bumper. Yeah, Christmas can't come soon enough as far as I'm concerned. I'm getting a bit tired. Just the daily grind. I find that towards the end of these days I always have 2 months off in the middle of, oh, sorry, 2 weeks off in the middle of the year and 2 weeks off at the end of the year. And as it gets closer towards the end of both of those breaks, I find myself just getting a bit knackered, a bit tired, mate. So hopefully we're even going to have enough. Brown and Mills, the five panels, I don't know. Using a bit more than what I expected, I reckon it's that bumper. That thing just chewed through it, man. So, I'll start on that other side. If I have to go out and mix more up, it'll just be for these two panels. That'll be the way to go. I might just make it, there we go. I just use fast hardener and the stand-up standard clear today. That cam's still rolling? Yep. Hey, I would so love to be able to use, slow hardener and all the jobs and wait for 10 minutes in between coats and, spend that extra bit of time on every job. And I'll get there one day, but for now, mate, I just got to make that money, get ahead in life. I'll slow down and take this channel maybe to the next level, and do some better quality work in the future. So stay tuned for that, but for now, mate, it's automotive smash. This is where the money's at. Rightio, so I don't think I'm going to have enough of those last two panels left. getting close. You know what? I'm going to go it, mate. I'm going to go it. If anything can do it, it'll be the pro load. We're gonna make it! We're gonna make it! Are we? Are we? I've had that on the replay, as I did like the last pass, and bang, it just puffed out of clear. I've done that on the replay before too. Absolutely no waste at all. And the entire job looks great. That is beast mode right there, man. Next level shit, mate. You know you're a pro when you're doing that. I'm pretty happy with that job. Let's have a quick look over the job. I'm wrapped with that. That's that nice Holden finish. Not too thick and chassis, not too dry. I actually don't mind the Holden finishes. I'm wrapped. I'm really happy with that. And now I've got my throat mark. I don't have to pull the GoPro off. Oh, sorry, the respirator off to give you guys a look over the job. This bumper here is where that extra 50 mils went easily. Look at the size of the bloody thing. It's massive. Really, really happy with that. Really, really happy. It's quite clean too. That's my happiness. There's a couple of bits around here, but nothing major, man. Nothing that won't polish out within half an hour. Yeah. Hope you guys like that throat mic too. I like it. On this end, it's better, I think, anyway. So yeah, I'm going to go give that 10 minutes, hit bake, give it 10 minutes, before I hit bake, sorry. And yeah, I'll see you in the next one, Gunners. Come on, one more look over it, you know you want it. So yeah, one down, on to the next one. I think I've got a little spot repair out there.
How dare you do a spot repair, Gunman? You're a hut!
Radio YouTube, see you in the next one. Coming out.